Good morning and welcome to the office. There isn't a golf video today simply because, well, I haven't played golf. Since the 24th of November, I've managed the grand total of 9 holes. That's because it's been so wet here and courses have been closed or they've been open with restrictions like carry only, or we've only got 8 holes and it's carry only. Trouble with carry only is what it says is, you lot over there, you can play. You lot over there, you can't play. You're elderly, you can't carry. You're female, you've never carried in your life, you've always had a trolley. You've got injuries, you can't carry either. So you lot can't play, but you can. You young fit men, you can play. I think it's a bit discriminatory, don't you? I mean, if the golf course is that wet that you can't have a pull trolley or a battery trolley, then quite frankly, the course should be closed, totally closed. Because if a trolley is going to do damage to the ground, what the hell do you think great big plates of meat are going to do? You know, feet are going to do the same amount of damage, if not more. Now, I can't carry. Because I've got these neck issues that I've had since 1990, even putting a dual strap bag on my shoulders, that weight pushing down, 26 pounds roughly, for 4 hours, well, I'm going to pay for it the next day or even the day after as well. So I don't carry, so I don't play. But to show what it's been like around here, here's a video of one of my local golf courses. And can you imagine the mess they got to clear up, the amount of silt and rubbish that's going to be deposited on the golf course? It's been terrible here. Enjoy. So yeah, that's what our golf courses look like at the moment. Even now, you know, this past weekend, this Easter weekend, it was reasonably dry just for a change. But I went on here, I went on quite a few websites and looking at golf courses, and there were so many restrictions. They only had a certain number of holes open, or again, it was carry only, which, as I say, is... it's discrimination. It's only going to take one grumpy old man to make some kind of official discrimination complaint because they haven't been able to play golf for 2 months while other people have been able to play golf, and it's going to hit the fan, isn't it? Right, this time of year is a time of year when I start, I go on here and I read the rules of golf. And then 2 weeks later, I will read the rules of golf again. I just want to imprint everything on my mind fresh at the start of the year. Then I don't do things wrong, like standing behind somebody while they're playing golf or standing behind them while they're putting to see how the ball moves across the green. I mean, you wouldn't want to break rules like that. So when I get into a situation this year, then the information about where to drop, how to drop, and whether it's a penalty or a free drop, and what size the penalty is, whether it's one shot or two shots, it's all fresh in my mind. And what's important about the rules of golf and knowing the rules of golf is it protects you against idiots. Let me give you an example. Let me take you back to May 1990. The 8th hole at Gloucester is a par 5 with a pond in the middle of the fairway. Now these days the pond has been dug out, there's a liner in it, it holds water all the time. Well, go back a few years, it was just a natural depression in the land which collected water when it really rained hard. The rest of the time it was dry. So much so that the greenkeepers would cut the grass with a strimmer down to about 3 or 4 inches. So if you went in this pond with its yellow stakes all the way around it, you could actually play out of it because it was dry. There was no water in it. Now, down the left-hand side, there was a couple of bramble bushes. There was even a couple of trees in it, which made for a great hazard, because if you chose to lay up short of the pond, you then had to be in the right place so that this tree wasn't in your direct line of fire. So anyway, I'm playing a competition. I've driven into the pond. So I walk in there with my bag on my back, because it was in the days before I had serious issues with carrying a bag, and bags were much lighter then anyway. So I walk into the pond, there's my ball. It's not lying great, but it's playable. So I take the bag off my back in the pond, put it down like this, pull out my 9-iron, lay the bag down in the pond. I get to the ball, I touch the top of the grass with my 9-iron. I then take a very careful backswing and find that I'm touching the bush that's in the pond. So I then adjust my aim, my stance if you like, and I touch the grass and I take this gentle backswing and I'm clear of the bush. So then I touch the top of the grass and I play out. I've done nothing wrong. The one guy says, "How many clubs have you got in your bag?" I said 13, because I only carried 13 at that time. He said, "That's a 26 shot penalty for grounding all your clubs. Then it's 2 shots for touching the grass, it's 2 shots for touching the bush, it's 2 shots for touching the grass, and it's 2 shots for touching the grass again. That is a total of a 34 shot penalty." I started sniggering a little bit. The other guy said, no, that's wrong. The maximum penalty you can apply for anything is 4 shots. So that's 4 shots for grounding all his clubs in the hazard when he put his bag down. And that's 4 shots for all of the times he touched various things in the pond. So that's a total of 8 shots. So he wanted to add 8 shots of penalty. Now, I finished the hole, and on the card, I was marking somebody's card, I put their score down in their score, and in the marker's score, I put down 5. Because I made a 5. So who was correct? Me with a 5, the one guy who said it was an 8-shot penalty, or the other guy who said it was a 34-shot penalty? Well, I'll tell you later what was the correct answer. Right, golf. I'm not playing golf because of the restrictions and because of how wet it's been. Although, look at the sunshine today. You know it's so sunny today, it's because I'm at work. I am now homeless. I do not have a home golf course. I've got nowhere to go and play. Wherever I go and play, I've got to pay a green fee, unless I go and drive an hour and a quarter out to West Monmouthshire. I've still obviously got that membership. But West Monmouthshire, even though it's a hilltop course, has been suffering from the rain as well. See, that turf up there is very peaty. So it absorbs the rain and holds it like a sponge. So it stays wet. Even though it's hilltop course, it stays wet. And they've had just as many closures as all the courses down in the valley. So I haven't been playing there. Why am I homeless? Well, I had 9 holes with my sons in first weekend of February. They only had 9 holes open, but you could take your trolley, so we went and played. My eldest son and his mates were talking about leaving Gloucester. And then at the last minute, the end of February, they rejoined, and they're going to have 1 more year there. Right, the battery died. It's been sat in the camera for months, and I suppose it drains the battery just being sat there keeping the system alive. So where was I? Right. So my eldest son and his mates have rejoined Gloucester, but they're going at the end of this golfing year. My youngest son bought his first house in September. He and his lady, he's moved out, and he wants to be a member of a golf course that is closer to where he lives and closer to where he works, so that he will play more and get more use out of his money, shall we say. So what do I do? Well, I thought, my eldest is fine playing with his mates and they're moving away anyway. My youngest is going on his own, and I thought I'll go with my youngest. So we have put our names on a waiting list for another golf club. We may not even get in this year. That's the danger of changing golf clubs, is you may not get in, you may get stuck on the waiting list. We won't know, really know, until about the first week of May. So for the moment, as I say, I am absolutely homeless with regard to having a home golf club. I had a golf lesson in the middle of February in anticipation that the weather was going to improve and golf courses would open, and it, of course, neither of those two things happened. So that lesson was kind of like wasted. All we did was basics. We did grip, stance, aim, posture. I was given some stretching exercises to do because obviously I've been not getting out and about. So I've been doing those stretching exercises, and email just came in. My body doesn't like it. And of course I've put on weight because I haven't been out playing or walking or doing anything. Obviously when you're bored, you eat crap, don't you? And I really am, now it's into April, I'm really starting to feel like a caged animal because I've looked at the weather forecast for this weekend. It rained both days, which means that golf courses are going to be either closed or carry only again. I have no idea when this golf year is going to begin. And it is very, very frustrating. Keep this video short, I won't say anything else other than the rules question. So, did you have a think about who was correct and who was incorrect and how many penalty shots I should have had? Well, after the round we sought out, I didn't sign my card because the guy marking my card had written 34 for the 8th hole. He decided that he was going to penalise, 34 penalty shots plus the 5 that I actually took. He wrote 39 on the card. So I went and sought out the competition secretary at Gloucester. And I said, he's given me 34 penalty shots for what I did on the 8th. He said, what did you do on the 8th? So I talked him through it. He said, so you didn't actually address the ball and thump your club down on the soil, you just touched the top of the grass blade. I said, yeah. He said, and you touched the bush. Did you knock anything off the bush? I said, no. He said, oh, in that case, cross, cross, 5. You see, you can do things in a hazard that don't actually break the rules. There's nothing to stop you walking into a bunker or a pond. You can even go waist deep in a pond if you really want to, although goodness knows how you would hit a golf ball that's 3 feet underwater. It would be impossible. So you can walk into a bunker with your bag of clubs, pick out your sandwich that you want to use, and put your bag down on the sand. You have not grounded your clubs. You have not broken any rules. You've done something rather silly, but you haven't actually broken a rule. And it was the same with this dry pond. You can walk into that pond, you can put your bag down on the ground in that pond. You can touch living things which are growing in the pond. Just so long as you don't actually ground your club. Grounding your club is not touching the top of the grass. Grounding your club is touching the ground. So I did nothing wrong. And this is why you should know the rules of golf. It's not just so that you can do the correct thing. It's to stop other people imposing the incorrect thing on you. And you'd be surprised how many people try and do that. Now, when I get into a situation, I'll normally say to my playing partner, this is what I'm going to do. And if a playing partner gets into a situation, he says, what do I do? I'm more than happy to say, I don't know, I can't quite remember, here's the rule book. Let's find it. There it is. That's what you do. But some people will try and impose their incorrect ruling upon you. So protect yourself. Read the rules to protect yourself. You know, golf is a funny game. It's one of those games you can play for 30 years and have no bloody idea of the rules. Could you imagine playing football for 30 years and not knowing the offside rule? And you can't understand why you playing centre forward, all your goals get disallowed. Well, I don't know. I don't know the rules. Or rugby, not knowing the offside rule. Or cricket. Well, I caught it. Yeah, but it bounced first. Yeah, but I caught it after it bounced. He's out. No, he's not out. You have to catch it clean. Do you? Well, I don't know the rules. You've been playing cricket 30 years. So, I don't know the rules. But golf, you can play for 30 years and haven't a bloody clue about the rules of golf. How to play the game. Strange, isn't it? Anyway, so until I actually get out on the golf course, until golf courses are fully open with trolleys, there's no golf videos. Oh, I'm going back to Thailand in November. My wife said to me, after that sour note of the previous holiday, she said, you can't finish on a sour note. You're going again. Go and have a good holiday. So that's exactly what I'm going to do in November. The only question is, will my golf be any good by November? Cheerio.